गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप एवरीवन इज फाइन एट होम. ओके, माय नेम इज मीनल एंड आई एम योर न्यू मैथ्स टीचर एंड आई विल बी टेकिंग योर मैथ्स सब्जेक्ट फॉर लाइक फ्रॉम नाउ ऑनवर्ड्स. ओके, सो फर्स्ट लेट अस स्टडी व्हाट यू हैव डन प्रीवियसली इन योर क्लासेस. ओके, सो यू हैव स्टार्टेड विद द फर्स्ट चैप्टर विच वॉज नंबर एंड कैलकुलेशन 1. ओके, so in that you have done addition and subtraction of integers. Okay, you have studied how to add and subtract positive as well as negative integers. Okay, so we will just have a recap of what you have previously done. So this is a table which I have made for you. This is the addition table. Okay, addition table of integers. If like the first integer if the first integer is negative and the second integer is also negative, then the operation what you have to do, that is you have to add those two numbers or you have to subtract those two numbers. That this will be your operation what you have to do, and this is the sign of answer. Means whatever answer you get, the sign of the answer will be this. Okay, so first is, if the first number is negative, the second number is also negative, then what you have to do is you have to add those two numbers. Okay, if both the numbers are negative, you have to add them and the sign of the answer will be negative. Okay, so your final answer will be negative. Now the next one is, if the first number is negative, the second number is positive, then you have to minus, you have to subtract those numbers, and the answer, the sign of the answer will be greater number sign. Means you have to check both the numbers, the number which will be greater. Okay, that will be your, that sign will be the sign of the answer. Okay, similarly for the next one, if the first number is positive, the second number is negative, then your operation will be subtraction. Okay, you have to subtract the two numbers and the final answer sign will be the sign of the greater number, whichever will be the sign of the greater number. Means suppose if the greater number is something and it has suppose negative sign, then your sign of the answer will be negative. Okay, now the last one, if all the signs are plus, means the first number is also positive and the second number is also positive, then your operation is to add them. Okay, both the numbers you have to add and the sign of the answer will be positive. Okay, so let us take some few examples before we go to our today's class. Okay, so these are your examples. I will help you in solving these. Okay, okay, so now let's do the first example. We will use this table, this addition table, and then the addition means this belongs to for addition as well as subtraction. Okay, I will tell you how to solve addition and subtraction sums using this table. Okay, so let's take the first example. In the first example you can see here the first number has no sign. If any number has no sign, that means it is positive. Okay, so the first number is positive and the second number sign you can see here, it is negative. Okay, so the first number is positive and the second number is negative. So in which category does it fall? This one. Okay, first is positive, second number sign is negative. So the operation what we have to do is we have to minus them, we have to subtract them. Okay, so we subtract 3 from 5. 5 minus 3, how much it is? 5 minus 3 is 2. Okay, so I write 2 here, so the answer is 2. And now we need to put a sign on this answer. So let's check what the sign will be for the answer is the greater number sign. Now which is the greater number from 5 and 3? Which is the greater number? 5 is the greater number. Okay, and 5, the number of sign 5, the sign of number 5 is positive. So the answer will be positive. Okay, so this will be your answer. So the answer of 5 plus negative of 3 is 2. Okay. Now the next example. In the next example you can see the first number is 2, which also has a negative sign, and the second number also has a negative sign. Okay, so in which category of this table does it fall? Both the numbers are negative. First number is also negative and the second number is also negative. So the operation which we have to do is add. Okay, so we have to add them. So 5 plus 2, if we add 5 and 2 we get 7. Okay, so your final answer is 7, and we have to put a sign also. So the sign which will come is negative. Why? Because here both numbers are negative. Even if we check the number which is greater, the greater number will also have a negative sign only. So the answer will always be negative if both the integers have negative signs, then the answer will also have a negative sign on it. Okay. Now the third example. In the third example, we see that the first number is negative and the second number is positive. This 10 has no sign here, means it is positive, right? So we have to, what do we have to do here in this case is, first number is negative, the second number is positive, then what we do? We subtract them. So we subtract 8 from 10, 10 minus 8 is 2. So your answer will be 2. Now check the greater number here, we have 2. The sign of the answer will be the greater number sign. So here which is the greater number? From 8 and 10, 10 is greater. So what is the sign of 10? It is positive. So your answer will be positive 2. Okay, plus 2. Now in the fourth case, this is a subtraction example. Okay, now here there is a slight change. What we have to do is, we don't have to directly refer to this table. Okay, what we do is, first check. Here there is a negative sign, there is subtraction. So what we do is, 4 minus minus 2, when there is a negative sign and the other number is also having a negative sign, then what it becomes is 4 plus 2. It becomes 4 plus 2. And now this is simple, 4 plus 2 is 6. So your answer will be 6. And here also if we check the greater number sign, the greater number is 4 and its sign is positive. So your answer will also be positive. Now here there is no need, if the answer is positive, there is no need to put a positive sign in front of it, okay? Only if the answer is negative, then you have to put a negative sign before it, okay? So this here, there is no need of putting a plus sign, okay? So if any number doesn't have a sign before it, that means it is positive. Okay, so in today's class, we are going to see multiplication of integers. Okay, so previously what you have studied is addition and subtraction of integers. Now in this class we are going to see how to multiply the integers, positive integers as well as negative integers. Okay, so for that we are going to make a new table, which is the multiplication table. The multiplication table is much simpler and smaller than the addition table. Okay, so first let's see what is there about the multiplication table. Now in the multiplication table, this is the first number. First number means the first number. These are the signs of the first number. Then these are the signs of the second number. If the second number is negative, second number is positive, okay? And this is the sign of answer. Sign of answer means the final answer. The sign of the final answer, what it is going to be. Okay, so now if the first number is negative and the second number is also negative, then the sign of the final answer will be positive, okay? Then the second thing is, if the first number is negative, the second number is positive, then the final answer will be negative. Similarly, if the first number is positive and the second number is negative, then the final answer will be negative. And the simplest one, if both the numbers are positive, then the answer will also be positive. Okay? And here, there is no operation column. Operation means we don't have to add or subtract here, right? What we are doing is multiplication. We are going to multiply the numbers. Okay, and one simple rule for this is, if both the signs are same, okay, means both the numbers have the same signs, either both are negative or either both are positive, then the answer will be positive, okay. If both numbers have the same signs, then the answer sign will be positive. And even if one of the numbers have a negative sign, okay, means both the numbers have different signs, means one is negative, other is positive, or the first is positive, second is negative, then the answer, the sign of the answer will be negative. Okay, this is the simple way to memorize this table. Okay, so now let's see some examples based on this table. Okay, so the first example is 4 into 5. Here both the, we can see that both the numbers have which sign? Positive sign. Okay, the first number is also positive and the second number is also positive. So what we do is, we multiply normally. So what will be the normal multiplication of 4 and 5? 4 multiplied by 5 is 20. Okay, so the answer is 20. And the final answer, the sign of the final answer will be plus, positive. Okay, so there is no need to write a plus here. This is, we know that this is positive. Now the second example we see. Now in the second example, the first number is having a negative sign. Okay, so the first number is negative and the second number is positive here. So what we do, first number is negative, second number is positive. So the answer will be negative. This is the sign of the answer. And what we have to do is we have to normal multiply. What is normal multiplication? 4 into 5 is 20. Only here what is going to change is the sign of the answer. The sign of the answer, what will be the sign of the answer is? If the first number is negative, second number is positive, then the sign of the answer is negative. So the final answer sign will be negative. Now here, both these multiplication numbers were same, right? First number was 4 and the second number was 5. So the answer will be same. Only the difference will be in the signs of the final answers, okay? The first here, both of the numbers were positive, so the answer is also positive. Here, one of the numbers is negative, so the sign of the answer is negative, okay? Now, the third example is similar to the second example. One of the two numbers are negative. So, what will be the multiplication? 2 into 4 is 8. 2 fours are 8. Now, the first number is positive, second number is negative. So, the sign of the answer is negative, okay? So, the sign of your answer will be negative. So, the answer is negative 8, minus 8, okay? Now, the fourth example. In the fourth example, both the numbers are negative, okay? So, we first normal multiply. What is 2 into 3? 2 multiplied by 3 is? 2 threes are 6, okay? So, 2 into 3 is 6. And if both the numbers are negative, then the sign of the answer will be what? Let us check. So, if both the numbers are negative, first and the second number is negative, so the answer, sign of the answer is positive. So, your answer will be plus 6, okay? Okay? So, these are when one of the two numbers are negative, then your answer will be negative. And if both the numbers are either positive or either negative, then the answer will be positive. Okay. So till now what we studied is if negative numbers are multiplied, like there were only two numbers, right? If either one was positive, the other one was negative, or the first one was negative, the second one was positive, or even both were negative. Okay, so there were only two numbers. And if there were two numbers, one of them was negative or both the numbers were negative. Okay. Now we will see how to solve multiplication sums if there are more than two negative numbers, okay? So, if there are three negative numbers, if three negative numbers are multiplied or if two negative numbers are multiplied, means there are three numbers but out of those three, only two are negative, okay? So, then what will be the sign of the answer, okay? So, this is what I have written on the board is a thing to remember, that is, if negative numbers are multiplied even times, the answer is positive, okay? That means if negative numbers are multiplied even times means 2, 4, 6, okay? So if there are two negative numbers, or if there are four negative numbers, or six negative numbers, or eight negative numbers, okay, that means the number of negative numbers is even, okay? If it is even, then the sign of the answer is positive, okay? Now the second thing is, if negative numbers are multiplied odd times, that means there are odd number of negative numbers, okay? That means there is only one negative number, or if there are three negative numbers or five negative numbers and so on, okay? That means odd times if they are multiplied, then the answer, the sign of the answer, the final answer will be negative, okay? So this you have to copy down in your notebooks. And now let us solve a few examples if the number of negative numbers is odd or even, okay? We will solve some examples, a few examples on based on these two sentences, okay? Okay, so now let us do some examples based on the thing, based on the two statements which we have studied. The first statement was, if there are even number of negative numbers, if even number of negative numbers are multiplied, then the sign of the final answer will be positive, okay? And if there are odd number of negative numbers multiplied, then the final answer will be negative, okay? So, this is a continuation of your exercise 1D, okay? So, just continue these sums after the first 4 to 5 sums which we have taken. You have to continue these sums after those, okay? So, let's check the first example. In the first example, first we have to multiply the numbers, okay? So, multiply 1 by 3, 1 into 3 is 3, then 3 into 2 is 6. Okay, so your final answer is the multiplication of these three numbers is 6. Now we have to check the sign of this number. Okay, sign of the answer. What will be the sign of this answer? So here we see that the negative numbers, how many are negative numbers? 1 is a negative number and this 2 is a negative number. So total how many negative numbers are there in this sum? There are 2 negative numbers. Okay, so 2 negative numbers means 2 is an even number. So if the number of negative numbers is even, then the answer of the final answer, sign of the final answer will be positive. Okay, so the answer will be plus 6, positive. Okay, now the second one, first let me multiply. So 8 into 2 is 16, 16 into 1 is 16. Okay, so the answer, the multiplication is 16. Now we check the number of negative numbers. How many negative numbers are there? 8 is positive, 2 is positive, here 1, only 1 is negative. So there is only one number which is negative. So 1 is what? 1 is odd. So if odd number of negative numbers are multiplied, then the final answer will be negative. Okay, so the final answer is negative. The sign of the final answer will be negative. So this is minus 16. Okay, now the third one. 4 into 3 is 4 threes are 12. 12 into 9 is 108. So the multiplication is 108. Okay, now 108. Now let's check the sign. Here how many numbers are negative? 3 and 9 both are negative. So there are 2 numbers which are negative. And 2 is what? Even. So if even numbers are multiplied, even number of negative numbers are multiplied, then the answer, the sign of the answer will be positive. So this answer will be positive. Okay. Now the fourth one. 8 into 2. First we multiply. 8 into 2 is 16. 16 into 1 is 16. 16 into 3 is 48. So our answer is 48. Now let's check the sign of the answer. How many numbers are negative here? 1 and 3 are negative. So there are 2 numbers which are negative. Okay. So if 2 numbers are negative, 2 is even. So if even number of negative numbers are multiplied, then the answer, sign of the answer will be what? Positive. So this is positive 48. Okay. Now the fifth example. In the fifth example, 5 into 4 is 20. 20 into 2 is 40. 40 into 3 is 120. Okay. So this answer, the multiplication is 120. Okay. Now let's check the sign. How many negative numbers are there over here? There are 3 negative numbers. Okay. 4, 2 and 3 all are negative. So there are 3 negative numbers. Now 3 is again odd. Okay. So what we do is we check the statement. The statement was the number of negative numbers is odd, then their multiplication will be also negative. Okay. So this will be minus 120. Okay. Answer is minus 120. Okay. Now the sixth example. Here it is 1 into 4 is 4. 4 into 4 is 16. 16 into 5 is, let's check. 16 into 5 is 5, 6 are 30. 5 1 are 5, 6, 7, 8. So the answer is 80. Okay. So your answer is 80. Now check the number of negative numbers. Negative numbers are 1. And 2. So there are 2 negative numbers. And 2 is what? Even. So the final answer will be what? Positive. Okay. If even number of negative numbers are multiplied, then the answer is positive. Now the 7th one. In the 7th one you check that all the numbers are negative. Okay. Here all the numbers are negative. But how many numbers are there? 4. Okay. So first let us multiply. 8 into 3. 8, 16, 24. 24 into 2 is 48. 48 into 2 is how much? Let's do 48 into 2. 2 8s are 16. 2 4s are 8, 9. 96. Okay, so the answer is 96. And what it will be? What the sign of the answer will be? Plus or positive or negative? Let's check. How many negative numbers are there? 4 negative numbers are there. And 4 is what? It is an even number. Okay. So if even numbers are there, even number of negative numbers are there, then the answer, sign of the answer will be positive. So this is positive. Will be the multiplication answer will be 1 into 1 into 1 is what? 1. So the answer will be 1. But what the sign of the answer will be? Okay. So sign of the answer will be what? Let's check how many negative numbers are there. How many negative 1s are there? 1, 2, 3. Okay, so there are 3 negative 1s. Okay, so 3 is an odd number, right? So, if there are odd negative numbers multiplied, then the answer will be negative. So, this is a minus 1. Okay, now the last example. In the last example, 1 again, minus 1 and minus 1, negative of 1 and negative of 1 is multiplied, so your answer will be 1. Okay, but what, negative or positive? Here, how many negative numbers are there? There are 2 negative numbers, right? And 2 is an even number. So, if even negative numbers are multiplied, then the answer will be positive. So, in this case, the answer is plus 1. Okay, so this, what was this about? If negative numbers are multiplied even times, the answer is positive. And if negative numbers are multiplied odd times, then the sign of the answer will be negative. Okay? So these were a few examples, and that is it about exercise 1D. So let us recap what all we have studied. Well, let us conclude what all we have studied in today's class. So first what we did is, we saw the multiplication table. Okay, in the multiplication table we saw if the two numbers are positive, then what will be the sign of the final answer. If the two numbers are negative, then what will be the sign of the final answer. If one of the two numbers is negative, then what will be the sign of the final answer. Okay, so if one trick I told you is, if both the numbers have the same sign, okay, like if both the numbers are negative negative or positive positive, then the sign of the answer will be positive. And the second trick was, if any one of the two numbers is negative, like if the first number is negative or the second number is negative, then the sign of the answer will be negative. Okay, then we solved a few examples on that based on the table, multiplication table. And now the second part was this, where we solved examples when the number of negative numbers was even and odd. The multiplication is simple, okay? We have to just multiply the numbers which are given, okay? Like here it was 4, 3 and 9. So we have to just normal multiply, but the sign will change. If the number of negative numbers changes, then the sign of the answer will also change, okay? So that's it for today. Let us meet in the next class. Till then, take care, okay students? Goodbye.